Hello guys, welcome back to the channel and to part three of this Tiger One tank build. So in this video today we're going to finish off the tank itself. This has been primed and painted, but the main body has been painted. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to get the fine detail all painted up. Okay, and we're going to see if we can try and get some weathering done on this bit as well. All right, so and also we're going to paint up the tracks as well. Paint the tracks up today as well. So we're going to get that done. Plus, we're going to get the jackals on as well. So let's crack on, shall we? Okay, we're going to use for the paint, we've got number 93 sand colour. For the rims of the wheels, we're using number 33 matte black. And for the tracks and the fine detail, it's number 53 gunmetal. So to start with, let's get the gunmetal. Get that all going. So we just do you know what? Just do that. Okay, we'll just come on through the bottom. We want to make sure that you get this well in between. Mm-hmm. Right, I'll leave that to dry for a bit. I'll do the other track as well. Might have to put some more in the pot if there. Leave that to dry for a bit. Okay, let's go and get some of the finer detail on the bodywork painted. I'm going to start with the machine gun. There we go, that's that out of the way. I do have a chain link here to do as well. Gonna have a look at some of the we got the that's the wire cutters, I think, there. we have a chain link here to do. We have a hammer here as well. And we've got the hammer, and we've got the shovel at the front there as well, so we've got to get that all painted up as well. I think we've got the our detail on the bodywork all sorted. Okay. Let's try getting some of the wheels on the tracks all painted now, so say what, let's just do it this way then. I can go over these later on with think I've got to try and somehow do the inside of the tracks as well. But this, Just for the record, I've used Halfords Grey Primer for this for priming. Okay. I think I've done the best I can with it. Well, I'll leave that to dry for a bit. Okay, right, we're going to get the wheel rims all done and dusted now, so getting them all painted up. And I'll just okay, I think I'll switch over to the hyperlapse now and get the rest of them done. Okay. Okay, it's now time for the turn of the decals. Now, I mean, I've done the best I can with the outline of the wheels as best I can, but all right, so let's try and get these decals on there, and okay, just use my paper towel to go wipe my brush off. And I think this is where I'm going to want decals, not tweezers as well. Want my tweezer set. So I'll use that one instead. Yeah. So I've got my scissors, and we want decal number one first to start with. So okay, right now then. First up, that is the marker set. Is to and what we're going to do is just let's get that all wiped off again now that I've got some of the markers set off. Okay. I've got my cup of hot water here. Decal's going in. Just get that out of the way, I don't want to knock it over. It's going to come over, this is going to come over just there we go, that's that. Right, now this is where we use the marker sole. And there you have it. That's that one on. Right, now we want decal number one of, there's two decal number threes. Okay. It's two decal number threes. Right, so we'll just move that out of the way for a minute. There we go. That's the comedy moment. There we go. There we go, right. Now I'm going to put it somewhere around about there, so. Just needs to come over just a tiny bit, I think. Yeah, I think we're okay with that one. Right. Let's get some marker set on there. Marker sole, sorry. There we go, that's it. That's in place now. Okay, I'll switch over to the hyperlapse and I'll get the other decals on. Alright. Seems to have messed up on the decals, but but anyway, because the one that's gone there has gone missing. It seems to have come off somewhere. Anyway, there it is. If I can see, it's right on my fingers. How did that get there? Right, I'll try and get that off. This one here is completely messed up. So, okay, so, so I don't know what's happened there. And the one on the back seems to have slipped as well, but. There we go, right. I think I'll just use some microset on that for the minute. On that one. Microsalt. Do the same on this one again. There we go. Right. Now, what I was going to say was I was going to do a bit of weathering. Just to highlight some of the detail and. Also, to try and get some muck in where the tracks are. Okay, so I'll be back in a bit. Okay, to highlight where some of the tools are and the chain links and all that. Okay, I'm going to be using some of that, which is humble black wash enamel. Okay, now. So I'm just going to highlight I think I've overdone it on that a bit, but there we go. I think that's all okay there, I think. Now then, let's try the I might do the chain link on the back as well, just to. Right, okay, now then, I've got some clean spirit here, so I'm going to use that as a now then, but for dirt, apparently this stuff is good for dirt anyway, so probably use that around the tracks, I think. So I don't know how, I've not tried this stuff before. It's Citadel Non Oil. Trying to give this a bit of a really heavy There we go. I'm trying to give that a bit of a, because dirt would accumulate around where the tracks are, wouldn't it? So I hope I'm doing all right with this anyway, because this is the first time we've used this stuff anyway, this non-oil. Right. Let's try and get some of that. Now, I'm just debating now whether to actually glue the tracks in, because no, do you know what? No, okay, no, I think I'll leave it. But anyway, that is seems to be well, I think I'll definitely use this. Use that again. Want to try and improve my weathering technique. Yeah. Shame about that decal though, because it's a good little kit to build. Okay, so I think we'll call it a day there. Well, that's it, guys, for this little build series. I've really enjoyed building the tank, and shame about that decal though. But I think I'll know next time not to go and fiddle with my decals while they're still drying. So yeah. Anyway, some news about the pole. Okay, it is. Get my phone up. I mean, it is very, very tight at the top between the K2Y ambulance and the HE111. Okay, 30%. On it's 30% on those at the minute, but this is at the time of filming, okay? So let me just point that out, okay? Because by the time this goes out on Wednesday, it'll probably change again. The Dornier is on 19%, and the Vickers. And the Vickers Wellington is on 22%, and that's after 27 votes. So anyway, get voting and see what you'd like me to build for the next weekend build series. So my personal preference would be the KT, but because I've never built a military vehicle before, apart from the tank. Okay, so there you go. Get my phone out of the way now. Now then, the next build series, the next mini midweek build series is going to be that. Okay, if you remember, this was joint second in the poll that I put up before New Year, and so I'll be doing an unboxing video of this next week. Okay, so there you have it, guys. If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up, why don't you? And comment as well, and share my video, share the videos as well, please, because it all helps to grow the channel. I'm gonna go back into YouTube Studio because I am now up to. I'm up to 303 subscribers, so anyway, please share the videos, okay? So in the meantime, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you for part 15 of the B17 build. Okay, part 14 is on now. Okay, I'll see you soon. Bye bye.